perception is that it's only injection drug users, and while that is a really easy way to spread this virus, it's not the only way.
Anytime someone was exposed to someone else's blood, you should be tested. And that could happen through people on dialysis, people with hemophilia, as well as people who inject drugs.
We also see people infected sexually, primarily men who have sex with men who also have HIV. That's the easiest place for transmission. Needle exchanges have done a really good job of reducing the spread of HIV. But we know that hepatitis C virus can live in cookers, cottons, and rinse water, probably for up to a week.
But what I think people haven't really appreciated is that in the 1960s and 70s, the virus had not been discovered. So many of those people may have been exposed actually through medical procedures. Now this means that if you're an American born between 1945 and 1965, you should be tested. And if you were exposed, there's a pretty good chance you're still carrying the virus today. The good news is that we can cure more than 95% of people who are able to start treatment and finish the course of therapy. So this is a cure, and I think part of our model is to empower people to achieve that.